dear children, now I am going to explain exercise 13.1, question number 7. Let's see the question.
A tent is in the shape of a cylinder surmounted by a conical top. If the height and diameter of the cylindrical part are 2.1 meter and 4 meter respectively, and the slant height of the top is 2.8 meter, find the area of the canvas used for making the tent. Also, one more question is here. Find the cost of the canvas of the tent at the rate of ₹500 per meter square. Note that the base of the tent will not be covered with the canvas. Base of the tent will not be covered with the canvas. Already I have drawn a figure, that is the tent. A tent is in the shape of a cylinder surmounted by a conical top. A tent is in the shape of a cylinder surmounted by a conical top. Upside it is a conical top. If the height and the diameter of the cylindrical part are 2.1 meter and 4 meter respectively, height of the cylindrical part is 2.1 meter and diameter of the cylindrical part is 4 meter. Height of the cylindrical part is 2.1 meter and diameter of the cylindrical part, upside and outside both it will be same only, that is 4 meter. And the slant height of the top is 2.8 meter. And the slant height of the top is 2.8 meter. So this slant height of the cone, it is 2.8 meter. Then what is the question? Find the area of the canvas used for making the tent. Area of canvas used for making the tent. And it is given there. Note that the base of the tent will not be covered with a canvas. This base of the tent will not be covered with a canvas. So we want to find out the canvas used to make this tent. That is, how can we find out that? Using canvas we are going to make the tent. Then how can we find out that? That is, this canvas we are going to put in outside only, that is outside covering and upside also. And here in this circular portion also we are not going to put the canvas. Okay, now I will show you the figure. Okay, now see, just like this, okay, it is in the form of a tent consists of a cylindrical part and upside it is a cone. This one is the cone. In this shape, okay, we are going to make that tent. How much canvas required to make this tent? That is the question. So, base it is, we no need of putting this canvas here in the base, already in the question it is given there. So, here we have to cover it with the canvas and here also we have to cover it with the canvas, that much only, that is the tent. So, how much area of canvas is required to make this tent? That is the question. So, how can we find out that? Area of the canvas required to make the tent is equal to curved surface area of the cylinder plus curved surface area of the cone. Then adding these two, we will get the area of the canvas required for making this tent. Okay, now, first we have to write the given values from the question, whatever values it is given here. That is, height of the cylindrical portion, it is given there. Height of cylinder. H is equal to how much meter? 2.1 meter. Height of cylinder H is equal to 2.1 meter. Next, diameter it is given there. Height and diameter of the cylindrical part are 2.1 meter and 4 meter. So, height is equal to 2.1 meter and diameter of the cylindrical part is equal to 4 meter. So, next we can write diameter of cylinder is equal to what is the value? 4 meter. Therefore, radius of cylinder. What will be the radius of cylinder? Radius of cylinder R is equal to 4 divided by 2, that is equal to 2 meter. This one is the diameter of the cylindrical part. Its radius, it will become half of the diameter, that is 2 meter. Now, if the radius of the cylinder is 2 meter, then what is the radius of this cone? Radius of the cone also will be same only, that is 2 meter. So, we can write that also. Then, therefore, radius of cone, radius of radius of cone. Also we can write small letter r, both value it is same only, that is 2 meter. Next one more value it is given there in the question, that is slant height. Therefore next we can write slant height of cone, slant height of cone used to denote the letter L is equal to 2.8 meter. Now this much value is only given here. Now we have to find the area of the canvas used for making the tent. Therefore area of canvas used for making the tent is equal to, how can we write that, curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area of cone. Curved surface area of cylinder, what is the formula? 2 pi RH plus curved surface area of cone, that is pi RL. Now substitute value here. 2 pi RH plus pi RL, 2 into pi value, what is the value of pi? 22 divided by 7 into radius of the cylinder. Radius of the cylinder R is equal to 2 meter into height of the cylinder. Height of the cylinder H is equal to 2.1 meter plus 2 into pi 22 by 7 into radius 2 meter into height H is equal to 2.1 meter. After that plus pi R L. Pi, that is 22 divided by 7 into radius of the cone. What is the radius of the cone? Radius of the cylinder and the radius of the cone, both it is same only, that is 2 meter into L, pi R L. L, that is the slant height of the cone. Slant height of cone is equal to, what is the value? 2.8 meter. Now, this one we can cancel. 2.1 divided by 7. 7 threes are 21, then 2.1 divided by 7, what will come answer? 0.3. 3 sevens are 21. 0.3 will come, 0.3 meter. Here also this 2.8 divided by 7 we can cancel. 28 divided by 7, 7 fours are 28. Then 2.8 divided by 7, what will come answer? 0.4 meter. 4 sevens are 28. Now multiply this. 2 into 22, 44. 44 into 2, that is 88 into 0.3, that is equal to 88 into 0.3 meter into meter, meter square plus, after that what is there, 22 into 2, 44 into 0.4, 44 into 0.4, there also meter into meter, it will come meter square. Now multiply this, that is equal to 88 into 0.3. 3 8s are 24 plus 2, 26, 1 decimal point is here, so it will come 26.4 meter square plus 44 into 0.4, 4 4s are 16, 6 remainder 1, 4 4s are 16 plus 1, 17, 1 decimal point is here that we have to put in the answer, so it will come 17.6 meter square. Now add it. 26.4 meter square plus 17.6 meter square. 26.4 meter square plus 17.6 meter square. 17.6 meter square. 6 plus 4, 10, 0, remainder 1. 10 decimal point, you will put it here. 7 plus 6, 13 plus 1, 14, 4, remainder 1. 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4. 44.0 means. So 44.0 means we can write 44 meter square. So 44 meter square canvas is required to make the tent. That is the first question. Find the area of the canvas used for making the tent. Area of canvas used for making the tent is equal to 44 meter square. Now one more question is also find the cost of the canvas of the tent at the rate of rupees 500 per meter square. If 1 meter square cost is rupees 500, then what will be the total cost of the canvas used for making the tent? What will be the total cost of the canvas? That means 1 meter square canvas is cost is rupees 500, then what is the cost of 44 meter square canvas? That is the question. So cost of
Next we can write cost of 1 meter square canvas is equal to what is answer? Rupees 500. Therefore, cost of canvas required to make the tent is equal to 1 meter square. That is 1 meter square canvas cost is ₹500. Then 2 meter square, how much it will come? Yes, ₹1000. How you will get that? 2 into ₹500. 3 meter square canvas cost 3 into ₹500. Then here total 44 meter square canvas is required to make the tent. Then cost of canvas required to make the tent is equal to how much it will come? 44 meter square into ₹500. That is equal to rupees. Multiply that. 4 fives are 20, 0. Reminder 2. 4 fives are 20 plus 2. 22. How many zeros are here? 2 zeros. So ₹22,000. That is the answer. Okay, dear children, now we will study question number 8. Let's see the question. From a solid cylinder whose height is 2.4 cm and diameter 1.4 cm, a conical cavity of the same height and same diameter is hollowed out. Find the total surface area of the remaining solid to the nearest centimeter square. We want to find out the total surface area of the remaining solid. From a solid cylinder whose height is 2.4 cm and diameter 1.4 cm. Then this one is the solid cylinder. Its height and diameter it is given here. Height is 2.4 cm. And the diameter 1.4 cm, its diameter is 1.4 cm. A conical cavity of the same height and same diameter is hollowed out. A conical cavity of same height and same diameter is hollowed out. From here, we are taking out this a conical cavity of same height and same diameter. This portion we are taking out from here, hollowed out, this one, just like a cone we have taken out. That is this one only. It is a, just imagine that it is a cylindrical, that is a solid cylinder, and from here a conical cavity of same height and same diameter we have taken out outside. This portion we have taken outside. That is the solid. This one is the cylindrical solid. Just imagine that it is a solid. Inside that it is full of solid. Just like a wooden solid. Just imagine that wooden solid cylinder. And from here, a conical cavity we are taking out from here. It will come just like this. That is this way. Conical cavity of same height and same diameter. Same diameter and same height we have taken outside. Conical cavity. Then question is, find the total surface area of the remaining solid. Just imagine that remaining solid, total surface area we have to find out. Then how much surface is there, or how much face is there, its area we have to find out. That is total area of the remaining solid, total surface area. Now you see, how can we find out the total surface area of this remaining solid? Now when we made this conical cavity, here there is a face, this one, a conical face is there. This conical face we have to find out, area of this conical face. And here curved surface area of the cylinder, and it is the area of a circle, area of this circle also we have to find out. So three faces are there. One is a circular face, and here a curved face, and inside that also a curved face is there. So these three faces area we have to add. That is the total surface area of this remaining solid. Okay, now we have to write the given values from the question. First we will write that. From a solid cylinder whose height is 2.4 cm and diameter 1.4 cm. So first we can write height of the cylinder. Height of cylinder h is equal to 2.4 cm and diameter 1.4 cm. Height of cylinder h is equal to 2.4 cm. Therefore, what is the height of this cone? Height of the cone also same only.
it is given there in the question, a conical cavity of the same height and same diameter is hollowed out. So height of a cone also we can write same, height of the cone is equal to 2.4 centimeter. And next it is given there, diameter of the cylinder is equal to 1.4 centimeter. Therefore, radius of the cylinder R is equal to 1.4 divided by 2, that is equal to 0.7 centimeter. 1.4 centimeter divided by 2, that is 0.7 centimeter. Therefore, radius of the cone, what will be the radius of the cone? Radius of the cone also will be same only. Radius of the cone R is equal to 0.7 centimeter. Okay, now we want to find out the total surface area of the remaining solid. Total surface area of the remaining solid, I told that curved surface area of the cylinder plus area of this circle, downside one circular face is here, area of the circle, and inside that curved surface area of the cone. Curved surface area of the cone, what is the formula? Pi R L. Curved surface area of a cone is equal to pi R L. L, slant height. Slant height of the cone, we need to find out the curved surface area of this cone. But slant height, it is not given here in the question. So first we have to find out that slant height. Slant height L is equal to, what is the formula? Next we will find out that slant height L is equal to square root of h square plus r square, that is equal to square root of height of the cylinder 2.4. therefore height of the cone also same only, that is 2.4. so h square we can write 2.4 square plus r square. Radius of the cone is equal to 0.7, that is 0.7 square, that is equal to square root of 2.4 square. 2.4 is multiplying 2 times, that is 24 into 24 we can multiply. 2.4 into 2.4, 4 4s are 16, 6 remainder 1, 4 2s are 8 plus 1, 9, 4 2s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 6, 8 plus 9, 17, 7 remainder 1, 4 plus 1, 5. Actually, we have to find out 2.4 into 2.4, so 2 decimal points are there, so that we have to put it in the answer, then it will come 5.76. So 2.4 square is equal to, it will come 5.76 plus 0.7 square. 0.7 into 0.7, 7 sevens are 49. Then 2 decimal points are there, so it will come 0.49. That is equal to, now add it, square root of 5.76 plus 0.49. 5.76 plus 0.49. 9 plus 6, 15, 5, remainder 1. 7 plus 4, 11 plus 1, 12, 2, remainder 1. 5 plus 1, 6. So it will come 6.25. Square root of 6.25. That is equal to square root of 625. We know that square root of 625. What is the value of square root of 625? Square root of 625 is equal to 25. 25 into 25. 25 square is square root of 625. Then square root of 6.25, what will come answer? That will come 2.5. 2.5 into 2.5, it will come 6.25. So square root of 625 is equal to 2.5 centimeter we can find. That is the slant height of the cone, 2.5 centimeter. Now we can find out the total surface area of the remaining solid. Therefore, total surface area of the remaining solid is equal to, therefore, total surface area of the remaining solid. Remaining solid is equal to curved surface area of a cone plus curved surface area of a cylinder plus area of base, or area of base we can write it as area of a circle. That is equal to curved surface area of cone, what is the formula? Pi R L plus curved surface area of cylinder, that is 2 pi R H, plus area of circle, that is pi R square. Now substitute value here, pi, 22 divided by 7 into radius of the cone, that is 0.7 centimeter into slant height L is equal to, we got answer here 2.5 centimeter, 2.5 centimeter plus 2 into pi, 22 divided by 7 into radius 0.7 centimeter into h, height of the cylinder. Height of the cylinder is equal to 2.4 centimeter, 2.4 centimeter plus pi r square is there, 22 divided by 7 into radius square, that is 0.7 centimeter into 0.7 centimeter, that is equal to 0.7 divided by 7, we can cancel, that is 0.1. 22 into 0.1, 22 into 1, 22, 1 decimal point we have to put, that much only, that is 2.2 into 2.5 centimeter into centimeter, centimeter square, plus here 0.7 divided by 7, 0.1, 2 into 22, that is 44, 44 into 1, 44, but 1 decimal point we have to put, that is 4.4, 4.4 into 2.4 centimeter into centimeter, centimeter square, plus 0.7 divided by 7, that is 0.1, 22 into 0.1, it will come 2.2 into 0.7 centimeter into centimeter, it will come centimeter square. Now multiply this, that is equal to 2.2 into 2.5. Multiply 25 into 22. 25 into 22, 5 2s are 10, 0, remainder 1, 2 2s are 5 plus 1, 2 2s are 4 plus 1, 5, 2 5s are 10, 0, remainder 1, 2 2s are 4 plus 1, 5, 0, 5, 5. How many decimal points are here? 1, 2. So 2 decimal points we have to put in the answer, it will come 5.50 centimeter square plus 4.4 into 2.4, 4.4 into 2.4, multiply that, 4.4 into 2.4, 4 4s are 16, 6, remainder 1, 2 4s are 8 plus 1, 9, same it will come here downside also, that is 6, 9, 6, 9 plus 6, 15, 5, remainder 1, 9 plus 1, 10, 2 decimal points are there, 2 decimal points are there, we have to put 2 decimal points there, so it will come 10.56 centimeter square plus 2.2 into 0.7, 22 into 7, multiply that, 22 into 7, 7 2s are 14, 4, remainder 1, 7 2s are 14 plus 1, 15, then 1, 2 decimal points are there, so it will come 1.54 centimeter square. Now add it, that is equal to 5.50, let me add here, 5.50 plus 10.56 plus last one is 1.54. Now add it. 6 plus 4, 10, 0, remainder 1. 5 plus 5, 10 plus 5, 15 plus 1, 16, 6, remainder 1. 5 plus 1, 6 plus 1, 7. 1 is here. So what is the answer? 17.60 centimeter square. 17.60 centimeter square, 17.60, that is the answer. But here it is given, find the total surface area of the remaining solid to the nearest centimeter square. So we will write nearest centimeter square means 17.60, we will correct up to the nearest whole number, that is 18 centimeter square. 17.60 centimeter square we can write as 18.0 or 18 centimeter square. So that is the answer, that is the total surface area of the remaining solid. Okay, now question number 9. A wooden article was made by scooping out a hemisphere from each end of a solid cylinder as shown in the figure. Figure, it is given there in your textbook also. A wooden article was made by scooping out of a hemisphere from each end of the solid cylinder. It is a solid cylinder. Just imagine that it is a wooden article. Just imagine that it is a wood. And this wood article made by scooping out a hemisphere from each end of a cylinder. Each end of a solid cylinder. Just like this. From this side, a hemisphere taken outside. From the outside also, a hemisphere portion we have taken outside. That is shown here in this figure. This one is a, it was a solid cylinder. From here, a hemispherical portion we have taken outside. From downside also, a hemispherical portion we have taken outside. Then, if the height of the cylinder is 10 cm and its base is of radius 3.5 cm, find the total surface area of the article. If the height of the cylinder is 10 cm, its height it is given here. This is the height of the cylinder, that is 10 cm. And its base is of radius 3.5 cm. Base radius is 3.5 cm. Base radius is 3.5 cm. Then upside also its radius will be 3.5 cm only. This radius also it will be 3.5 cm. Then what is the question? Find the total surface area of the article. Now how can we find out the total surface area of the article? Just imagine that. Then this one is a solid cylinder. From here a hemispherical portion we have taken outside. Now from downside also a hemispherical portion we have taken outside. That is the article now. Now total surface area means, now you see, downside a cylinder, then this hemispherical surface it will come. Upside also a hemispherical surface is there, and the side curved surface area of the cylinder. All these three faces we have to add. That is the total surface area of this article. Then how we will get that? Total surface area of the article is equal to curved surface area of the cylinder plus curved surface area of the hemisphere plus curved surface area of the hemisphere. Remember, downside also it is a curved surface area only. So total surface area of the article is equal to curved surface area of the cylinder plus curved surface area of this hemisphere plus curved surface area of the hemisphere. Both radius it is same only. Radius of the hemisphere it is same only, 3.5 cm. So first we have to write the given values. That is, first it is given here, height of the cylinder. Height of the cylinder it is given there. Height of the cylinder h is equal to how much centimeter? 10 cm. Then radius of the cylinder. Radius of the cylinder r is equal to 3.5 cm. Therefore, what is the radius of the hemisphere? Radius of the hemisphere also same only. Radius of the hemisphere. Radius of the hemisphere r is equal to, that also same, 3.5 cm. Therefore we can write, therefore total surface area of the article. Total surface area of the article is equal to, total surface area of the article is equal to curved surface area of cylinder, curved surface area of cylinder plus 2 into curved surface area of hemisphere. 2 into curved surface area of hemisphere. How comes 2 into curved surface area of hemisphere? Curved surface area of hemisphere, curved surface area of hemisphere. So 2 curved surface area, 2 hemispheres are there. Both radius same only, so it's a curved surface area, this curved surface area it will come same only. So we will find out the curved surface area of one hemisphere. Into 2 we will multiply, then both the curved surface area we will get. That is why I wrote here 2 into curved surface area of hemisphere. That is equal to curved surface area of cylinder. What is the formula? 2 pi rh plus 2 into curved surface area of hemisphere. 2 into curved surface area of a hemisphere. What is the formula? 2 pi r square. That is equal to, substitute value here now. 2 into pi, 22 divided by 7 into radius of the cylinder. Radius of the cylinder is equal to 3.5 cm. 3.5 cm into height of the cylinder. Height of the cylinder h is equal to 10 cm. 10 cm plus 2 into pi, 22 by 7 into radius 3.5 cm into height h is equal to 10 cm. After that, what is the sign? Plus 2 twos are 4 into pi, 22 divided by 7 into r square, radius of the hemisphere. What is the radius of the hemisphere? Radius of the hemisphere also same only, 3.5 cm. R square means r into r, that is 3.5 cm into 3.5 cm will come, that much only, that is equal to. Now, 2 into 22 by 7 into 3.5, 3.5 divided by 7 we can cancel. 7 5s are 35, so 3.5 means it will come 0.5. 2 2s, 3.5 divided by 7, 7 5s are 35, so 3.5 divided by 7 it will come 0.5. 2 into 22, that is 44 into 0.5 into 10. What will come, answer? one decimal point will go one place right side, then it will become 5 centimeter into centimeter, centimeter square plus. Here also 3.5 divided by 7 we can cancel. 7 5s are 35, so 3.5 divided by 7 it will come 0.5. 4 into 22, that is 88, into 0.5 into 3.5, 35 into 5, multiply that, 35 into 5, 35 into 5, 5 5s are 25, 5 remainder 2, 3 5s are 15 plus 2, 17. Then how many decimal points are there? 2 decimal points are there, so it will come 1.75. 88 into 1.75 centimeter into centimeter, that is centimeter square. Then that is equal to, multiply this, 44 into 5. 4 5s are 20, 0, remainder 2. 4 5s are 20 plus 2, 22, 220 centimeter square plus 88 into 1.75, that is 175 into 88 we can multiply. 8 5s are 40, 0, remainder 4. 7 8s are 56 plus 4, 60, remainder 0, 6, 0, remainder 6. 8 ones are 8 plus 6, 14. The same will come here also, 0, 0, 4, 1, 0, 0, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, 1. Then how many decimal points are here? 2 decimal points, 175 into 88, 2 decimal points are there. So 2 decimal points we have to put in the answer, so what will come answer? 154.00, that we can write, 154 centimeter square. Now add these two, we will get the answer, that is 154 plus 220. 154 plus 224, 5 plus 2, 7, 2 plus 1, 3. That is equal to what is the answer? 374 centimeter square. That is the total surface area of the article.